So welcome back to yet another edition of the supercharged version of Cross Connection in Pajamas. I'm in my pajamas. I hope you guys are in your pajamas. So how has the quarantine been? I know it's been a hard time and this lockdown doesn't seem to end. Whatever this time that we have in isolation, we must utilize it. And that is why we are here with Cross Connection online. We don't know when we can meet in person yet, but we're hoping that we can all celebrate our joy together in person real soon. But meanwhile, I want to welcome you guys for this virtual edition of Cross Connection. Any guesses what is our theme for this month? I'm sure everybody already knows. Supercharged, yes. So we are supercharged. We're all supercharged, and this is the supercharged edition of Cross Connection. And I know that you're all excited to be here. This is our monthly gathering. For those of you who are joining in for the first time, welcome to JY Delhi's monthly gathering called Cross Connection. So this is Cross Connection, and I want to welcome all of you for this virtual edition of Cross Connection. So during these last few days, actually, we've been doing this small challenge and we've been asking people that what has been keeping you guys supercharged during this quarantine. So I want you all to put in the comments all that, you guys have been doing to keep yourself supercharged. Thank you for the virtual hugs. So one thing that has been keeping me supercharged is actually baking. And today is Father's Day and I baked a cinnamon chocolate cake for my dad. And that's how I was keeping myself supercharged today. And previously, I've been doing the same. I've been baking a lot, cooking a lot. Every time I'm feeling low, I think I go to YouTube, find a new recipe, and I'm cooking something new. And actually, the fun thing is my brothers have been, really... they've been the one who's been eating all the amazing food that I've been making. I'm calling my food amazing myself. I'm a little I like to encourage myself and tell myself that my cooking is amazing. So my brothers have been having a good time just eating all these good dishes. And like that, a lot of us have been doing different things to keep ourselves supercharged. And I want to hear all that you have been doing to keep yourself supercharged. I see Alicia, who said that she's been eating a lot. Yes, Alicia, I'm there with you, girl. Like, we've been eating a lot. And I think we might have to start working out real soon. So what else, guys? What else? Painting and reading memes. Wow, that's reading memes. I like that. Painting, that's great, Aishwarya. What else? Parampuri. Wow, Jason Joseph loves parampuri. That's great. I love parampuri. Actually, the funny thing is, Jason had come to my place a few weeks ago and I made him parampuri. I think he's talking about my parampuri, right, Jason? Just kidding, guys. What else has been keeping you guys? Oh, Robin, sleep. Oh yes, Robin, me too. I feel like I wake up in the morning and then I feel sleepy again, and I go to sleep, and then again I wake up, and then again I sleep. So I feel like I've been sleeping a lot too. Although you wrote sleep, yes, sleep, yes. So we all love sleeping, right? Okay. What else? So Rosalind says she's been eating, reading, praying, cooking, keeping in touch with dear ones. Wow, Rosalind, you've been doing a lot. It's great. All of this is keeping you supercharged. Firoz, all the way from Spain, is here, our beloved Firoz Bhaiya. And he's been doing boxing. Wow, Firoz Bhaiya, I think you have to come back and, you know, you have to give us some boxing lessons. What else? Joel Phillips says video calls have been keeping him supercharged. Wow, that's great. I see that. I see Joel and my brother's name. He's also Joel. Most of you might know him. So these guys talk a lot on video calls. And, you know, I've never seen guys talk a lot on video calls. I thought it was a girl's thing. But I think this isolation, this quarantine has made all of us, you know, just talk a lot to our friends. So it's great, Joel. Good to listen from you guys. TikTok, wow, Anne Maria Princess TikTok. You know, you should actually delete TikTok because it's a Chinese app. Okay, just kidding. And you don't have to. It's totally your choice. So moving on, we are super excited to be here. And I want to welcome all of you guys who just joined in. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this supercharged edition. You know, I think I had to drink like two glasses of Glucon-D just to keep myself supercharged. No, just kidding, I didn't. So we've been here again to celebrate our supercharged edition of Cross Connection, and we will be starting with our virtual Cross Connection with a quiz. So hands up, just give me a hi on the comments. Who's excited for a quiz? Dikshit Bhaiya, if you can slowly start putting up our quiz questions, it'll be great. Okay, so here's the first question. How many days after Jesus ascended into heaven were the apostles filled with the Holy Spirit? So your first option is one day after Jesus ascended to heaven. Option two is three. Option three is 10. And option four is 15. So what's the right answer, guys? Please put in your answers on the comments. Yes. Okay. So the first person to say 50 was Alicia. Yes, Alicia was the first person to say 50. A lot of people have been putting 10. 50, 10, 50. I'm glad no one thinks it's 1 and 3. Oh, 2. Option 2. Okay. 50. Okay. Great. So, yes. So, our winner for this question is Alicia. Alicia, after this lockdown, whenever we meet, just come and ask me for your gift. I'm going to give you a 5 rupee munch. I love munch, you know. So, I'll be doing you a great favor if I give you something I really love. So, yeah. Next question is, what sound was heard all around the apostles when they gathered together on Pentecost? So our first question, our first option is laughing children. Second option is rushing wind. Third option is gurgling water, and fourth one is crackling fire. So what is our answer, guys, to this question? Wow, Jaren Vargas has already guessed our answer, but I'm going to keep going. Rushing wind. Okay, rushing wind. So that's our right answer. Jaren was the first person to give the answer. Yes, Jaren. So our winner for this question is Jaren. Jaren, you can come and ask me for a munch when we meet next, okay? I love you. That's why I'm going to give you my munch. Okay, next question, Dikshit Bhaiya. Which council of the Holy Church defined the Holy Trinity? Okay, now this might be a tricky question, so I want you guys to probably just revise your catechism lessons, but do not Google the answers, okay? You know, we are here for cross-connection. We're all J-wise. We don't cheat, right? So first option is Second Vatican Council. Second option is Council of Nicaea. Third option is Council of Hippo. And our fourth option is Council of Constantinople. So let's see what answers everybody has. Okay, Council of Nicaea, Council of Hippo, Second Vatican Council. Wow, you know, Second Vatican Council only happened like a few years ago, and we've been believing in the Trinity for a very long time, guys. Okay, so the first answer, I mean, the first correct answer option was given to us by I think it was Jaren again. Jaren, this is not fair. You should wait for others to give the right answer. So Jaren again is our winner. So Jaren gets another munch from me. Yes, the right answer is Council of Nicaea, which happened in 8423. Yes. 8325. Sorry, 8325. Yeah, my bad. Yeah, so that was Council of Nicaea, and Jaren is our winner. Fourth question is, what does the word Catholic mean? Number one is Earth. Number two is Roman. Number three is Universal. And number four is Papal. So what does the word Catholic mean? Yeah, like Alan says, Jaren, stop it, man. Yeah, Jaren, you can't answer anymore, okay? Even if you know the answer, just keep quiet. Okay, we are getting some answers. Wow, so everyone has guessed it right. I'm proud of you guys. You guys have been taking your faith very seriously. Yes, the word Catholic means universal. And I think a lot of them put in the comments together. But I think the first one was Abhishek Nair. So yes, Abhishek, when I come and ask me for a munch, I'll give you a munch. Okay, so we will have our last question. Okay, which is the latest encyclical written by Pope Francis? Now, this again might be a little tricky question, but it's not really hard. First one is Christus Vivit, which means Christ is risen. Second one is Laudato Si. Third option is Lumen Fidei. And the fourth one is Amoris Laetitia. So what are your options? What are your answers, guys? Just put it in the comments. So the first one to give the right answer is Michael. Michael says it's Laudato Si. Actually, a lot of people have written Laudato Si. Kelvin Matthew says Christus Vivit. Kelvin, Christus Vivit is actually an apostolic exhortation. It's not an encyclical. Laudato Si was the very last encyclical which was written by Pope Francis. So Michael, you actually live quite close to my house. So if you want, you can come and say hi to me and take your munch. So we have our amazing winners. Good job to all of you. I think a lot of you guys might have guessed the right answers, but maybe your internet connection is a little slow, just like mine. So it's okay. Next time we can try and, you know, we can give the right answers first. So moving on to our supercharged cross-connection edition. actually, just before that, I want to give a small heads up. Like, if we are facing any technical glitches, just forgive us and please bear with us. Some of our internets might be a little slow, and you know, what can we do? Internet is always slow, man. Can't help it. So just be with us, okay? And I request all of you to stay till the end. We have a lot of amazing things coming up. We have amazing people who are going to lead us in praise and worship, an amazing person who's going to give an amazing talk. And we also want to meet Jesus in the Eucharist towards the end. So do wait for this Cross Connection edition to end. Just wait till the end. Okay, so moving on, I am actually going to invite someone very special. So any guesses who's coming? We had a few like reveal videos. So any guesses who is coming as our music resource? So next we'll have some time to just sing, clap, praise the Lord with all our hearts. So who is coming? Come on, guys, just give me some guesses. Just give me some guesses. Who can it be? Guys, yes, Robin. Robin, you've been guessing a lot of right things, huh? Yes, it is Sini Maria. Yes, it is Sini Didi, who is our, she's our favorite person. And we Delhiites keep inviting her for a lot of things. And why not? Why shouldn't we invite her? She's part of the Delhi band, the Acts of the Apostles. She's the lead vocalist. She's the lead vocalist. She's a very talented musician. She's an amazing wife. She's an amazing mother. She's also, you know, pursuing her PhD in MSW. Although she only looks like a 12th standard girl, but you know, she's like a really big shot person. So I want to welcome Sini Chechi. I want to welcome Sini Chechi into our virtual edition of Cross Connection in Pajamas. Welcome, Chechi. I hope you're in your pajamas. I'm in my pajamas. And just want to welcome you in this supercharged edition of Cross Connection. Chechi, we can't hear you. Can you check the mic? Yes. Okay. Yeah. So welcome, Chechi. As you know, this is our supercharged edition. I have a question for you. So what has been keeping you supercharged during this, you know, endless period of quarantine and this pandemic? What's been keeping you supercharged?
Ria, I think I've also been trying to bake a couple of things like you have been, and also trying to learn a little more about music because I realize I'm very limited in my understanding, so just trying to understand a little more of whatever I can, and yeah, mainly that's about it.
Yes. Yes, Chechi, good to know. I think once this quarantine ends, we'll all have amazing bakers and people who can cook, and they'll be like this MasterChef. You know, we'll have so many more contestants in the next MasterChef.
Absolutely.
So good to know, Chechi. Another thing I want to ask you is, how has your quarantine been otherwise? Like, how's your spiritual life? How's that been going? And what have you been keeping? What have you been doing yourself to keep your spiritual life supercharged?
Yeah, so one thing that I have been, actually, I feel we're very privileged as Catholics, you know, this gift of community and this very big gift of technology that keeps us together in these times when a lot of people around us are still, losing hope and are very anxious. I feel technology is one thing that has brought us all together. So we've been attending daily Mass, and personal prayer is obviously another thing that happens. And very recently, I was very lucky to have received the communion. yeah, so that was like a big blessing and a big surprise, because I think it was just last Sunday that I just made a prayer that, Lord, if I get a chance, if I can just receive you for once. And then the next day, I get a call from one of our JY priests who happened to be around. And it was such a blessing. So that was beautiful.
That's so cool, Chechi. Even I got to attend Mass last week, and it was a different experience altogether. And I was like, wow, like, you know, I've been away for so long. 3 months, I was somebody who was trying to attend a daily mass, but suddenly when this mass is taken away from you, it's really hard to cope up. And I'm glad that we were still able to be connected online and we were all attending online mass. I think that's a beauty that we only see in the Catholic Church, right? I don't know if Hindus and Muslims were attending online services. I mean, that's something that's just so unique to us, and praise God for that. So, yes. Tracy, I want to next, I just want to leave it to you, and I just want to welcome you once again. And as a lot of people have been saying, welcome, Chechi. A lot of your fans are here, by the way. A lot of people who love you are here, and they've been excited to hear you. So, Chechi, all to you, and thank you for being with us.
Thank you so much, Riya, and thank you to all of you who've joined for this, the virtual version of Cross Connection. I'm really glad to be in Delhi virtually, thank you once again for all your love. And now I think we'll just take a few moments of this precious time that we have to just spend time with the Lord and just prepare ourselves. Let's just calm ourselves down. And I would just like to share a verse with you before we enter into a small time of praise and worship. And I would like to begin by Psalm 145 verses 1-3, which says, that I will proclaim your greatness, my God and King. I will thank you forever and ever. Every day I will thank you. I will praise you forever and ever. It's up on the screen, so we can all just read it together wherever we are. Call thee, my God and King, and bless thy name forever and ever. Every day I will bless thee and praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. My version says that his greatness is beyond our understanding. So let us just spend these few moments. Let's just take this time to praise this God of ours for the beautiful God that he is, the beautiful Father that he is, by singing this song, How Great is Our God. I invite you all to sing along and just worship him as we sing together. The splendor of a king, cloaked in majesty, let all the earth rejoice. All the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. Let's sing this together. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God. How great is our God? How great is our God? Sing with me. Is our God, and I will see how great is our God. Age to age he stands, and time is in his hands. Beginning and the end, beginning and the end. The Godhead three in one. Oh, the Father, Spirit, Son. The Lion and the Lamb. The Lion and the Lamb. How great.
Sing with me halfway. Isaka and I will see how great, how great is our God.
Thank you, Jesus.
You're the name above all names. You are worthy of our praise. And my heart will sing, how great is our God.
Let's sing it out.
You're the name above all names. You are worthy of our praise. And my heart will sing, how great is our God.
How great is our God.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And I will see how great is our God.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's just take these few moments to praise God. Let's open our arms, extend them towards this great maker of us, this great God of us, and sing out to him. Let's just praise him. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We glorify you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise and bless your name, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Father, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Loving Lord, we want to thank and praise you for your beauty, for your goodness, for your mercy, and all the good things that we experience from you as a good, good Father that you are. Lord, we thank you for having kept us in the hollow of your hand all this while, amidst all this chaos and confusions that we hear of and see from day to day. Lord, you have kept us safe as you have promised. And we thank you, Lord, for all your promises. We thank you for your faithfulness, God. Loving Lord, we at this moment are reminded of today's gospel that we heard, where you are assuring us, you're strengthening us by your words, which say from the book of Matthew that even the hairs on our heads are counted. That is so assuring, Lord, to know that none of our struggles that we may be personally undergoing or suffering from, any of our sufferings, be it the smallest, the minutest, go unnoticed, Lord. Lord, you have a record of all these things, Lord Jesus, and you allow all these sufferings and struggles in our lives with a purpose to refine us and make us more righteous and perfect like you, our Father, our Lord. Lord, we want to thank you for your assurance and for the strength that you give us in these times of uncertainties, Lord. Let us just take these moments to bring before the Lord any such struggles that we are facing right now and surrender it. Let us take it to the Lord and surrender them. Our God who knows everything about us. Our God who's carved us and our names on the palm of his hand. Let's just take all these things that we haven't done already. Let's just take it to the Lord in prayer. As we continue to remain in this moment of praise and adore him. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And right now, as we are constantly reflecting, as we experienced and celebrated the Feast of Pentecost a couple of weeks back, and as we continue to ponder and meditate on how we as individuals can live our call of the Pentecost in the present situations, let's just bring before us, let's just recall to our minds how the apostles would have been when suddenly they realized that Jesus was not physically present with them. That the Lord, the mighty God, the Son of God, who was with them all the time, healing people, performing a lot of miracles. And suddenly, when Jesus left them, he ascended into heaven. And the apostles experienced a lot of anxiety, a lot of confusions, a lot of fears. They did not know what was going to happen next. But they waited. They held on because of the promise that Jesus had made to them. And so I think we also are very similar in that particular context. We also are experiencing a lot of confusions, a lot of anxieties, things not going as per our plans. So we too have been like the apostles who experienced a lot of anxieties and fears at that point in time as they had gathered together in that upper room. And then a beautiful thing happened, and that was that the Holy Spirit came upon them, descended upon them like tongues of fire. And as a result, what happened is that the apostles became so bold that they no longer feared anything or anyone. They just went about proclaiming, or the work that they were called to, they went about very fearlessly doing just that. And that was to proclaim about God's love, his forgiveness and repentance. It is so beautiful about when the Holy Spirit comes, or how our lives are just transformed. It's just turned upside down. And I feel today, as we reflect about how we as individuals can live our calling of this, of the Pentecost, of the same experiences that we had with this Holy Spirit living in us, let us pray to this Holy Spirit of God, to that same Holy Spirit who gave the apostles that courage and the strength. Let's pray to the Holy Spirit to make it clear to us on what our vocations are, on what our ministries are, even in this time of lockdown. There is so much more that we would be able to do, and the Holy Spirit will reveal it to us when we call on to him. So as we sing this final hymn of worship, let us sing this song sincerely, make it a prayer to the Holy Spirit that he guides our vision, that he guides our understanding, especially in these times that are so uncertain. Let us pray for his wisdom, and to come for him to come upon us in a very strong and powerful way. Holy Spirit, guide my vision.
Holy Spirit, guide my vision. Help me see the way you see. Always Jesus, ever Jesus. Christ in all is Christ in me. Holy Spirit, guide my speaking, words of grace and truth abound. Let my lips be filled with stories of the mercy that I found. You're the light, you're my path, you're the shepherd of my soul. All I am, all I have, Holy Spirit. Trusting, leaning, holding, clinging till the day you lead me home. Till the day you lead me home. You're the light, you're my path, you're the shepherd of my soul.
Spirit, for your presence in our lives. Thank you for being that guide which our Lord promised will be with us always. Today, as we are in this period of lockdown and with not much to do in our limited understanding, we bring before you all that we have, all our resources, all our abilities and talents, all our limitations, and we pray that by your power, O Holy Spirit, our lives be transformed. Enable us, O Holy Spirit, to be the light and the salt of the earth. Wherever we are in our current situations, help us to be more sensitive to your promptings and praise God and glorify God through all that we do. For this grace, we pray in the sweetest name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you so much for leading us into a beautiful time of praise and worship, JJ. It's just so beautiful to praise God, and especially we celebrated the Pentecost a few weeks ago, and especially now that we are still in that, still in that celebration, and still like learning to live with the Holy Spirit and learning to listen to the promptings of the Holy Spirit. I think that that song was very apt. So thank you so much, Chichi. Sini Chichi will actually be joining us back soon. Next, we shall now be moving on to our sharing, to our talk of the day. For this, we have again another amazing person. Any guesses? Who's going to guess? Let me see. Who's our lead resource, guys? Who's the one who's going to share our share the word of God, or bake the word of God with us today? Come on, guys! I need guesses. I don't see much comments here. We need to be supercharged throughout the CC and throughout this pandemic, actually, throughout our lives. We need to be always, always be supercharged. So, who is our resource for the day? Any guesses? Okay, some hints. So he actually is a full-time missionary. He works... he is the secretary of Evangelization Commission for the Archdiocese of Delhi. We actually invite him a lot to our JY programs, and he's always so willing to come and talk to us and share his knowledge with us. Who else? I mean, what else? He has two amazing children. He has a beautiful wife. Some people are guessing Vivian Bhaiya. Vivian Bhaiya doesn't have two beautiful children yet, but he soon will. So it's not Vivian Bhaiya. It's not David Bhaiya. Okay, so Alisha has guessed it. It is Matthew Bhaiya. Yes. So Matthew Bhaiya, I want to welcome you to our supercharged edition of Cross Connection. He's going to join us shortly.
Thank you.
Hi, Matthew Bhaiya. How are you?
Very well. Very well, Riya.
So, Bhaiya, as you know, this is our supercharged edition of Cross Connection. I have a small question for you. What is it that has been keeping you supercharged during this pandemic?
I don't know about other days, but today, definitely the Cross Connection has been keeping me supercharged.
Yeah, that's awesome. I think that's been keeping all of us supercharged. It's great. It's giving me a lot of energy too. So I'm usually not this energetic. So yeah, I think.
Really? I was really thinking you have a lot of energy and you are really supercharged.
Uh-huh. I'm glad you think like that, Bhaiya. Yes. Actually, I want to introduce Matthew Bhaiya real quick. So he has a beautiful wife and two beautiful daughters. He is the Secretary of Evangelization Commission with the Archdiocese of Delhi. And he's always willing to help us JYs for every event that we invite him to. I remember Matthew Bhaiya from, when I was in school in St. Anthony's School, he used to come and give us catechism lessons and give us retreats. And I remember, I think, third, fourth standard onwards, I've been seeing Matthew Bhaiya.
You're dating me.
Almost 20 years. And, Matthew Bhaiya has always been a constant inspiration, and you've always inspired us girls. So as with a girls' school, and you've inspired us girls, and I'm sure you've inspired thousands of youth across the country. So thank you so much for joining us in this virtual edition of Cross Connection, Bhaiya, for the supercharged edition of Cross Connection. Thank you, and over to you now.
Thank you, Riya. Thank you, and thank you, Sini, for that beautiful worship that you led for us. I'm sure the Lord is at work. Before I begin, let's just say one Hail Mary to Our Lady. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. We sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. We are 21 days exactly after the Feast of Pentecost. Now, when Riya was doing this quiz, I was reminded of a question that I heard, something similar. Somebody asked, how long does it take to reach heaven? So, nobody has traveled that and come back. So we can't tell you that. So somebody said, then people gave different type of answers. Then the person who was asking the question, he came back and said, it takes 5 days to go to heaven. The distance from heaven to earth or earth to heaven is 5 days. And what's the logic? The logic is this. On the 40th day after resurrection, Jesus ascended into heaven. Okay, and on the 50th day after resurrection, that's 50 days, we have the Feast of Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came down. So 5 days for Jesus to go up and 5 days for the Holy Spirit to come down. So now that's a joke, okay, and don't take it seriously. It won't take you that long. You'll be there in a glimmer, okay, like within seconds you will be there. Okay, so the topic for us, supercharged, and the Holy Spirit, I just want to ask you all, wherever you are, you need to post this on your chat windows. What is the difference that the Holy Spirit made in the life of the disciples? When we look into the Acts of the Apostles, we find that one of the first things that the disciples experienced when the Holy Spirit came was they were all, the fear within them. We know the story, how Peter was so scared that one little servant girl called him out, and he said, you are one of his disciples, He said, no, I don't know him. Not once, not twice, three times he denied Jesus. Itna jada dar. But that same Peter, on the day of the Pentecost, when he received the Holy Spirit, this Peter could stand in front of thousands of people. You know, Pentecost was a feast, Jewish feast, that predates, you know, the understanding of the feast that we have now. You know, the Jewish people celebrated for eons, no, like this Feast of Pentecost. And on that day, when thousands of Jewish people from all over the world were gathered together in Jerusalem, Peter could stand in front of them and proclaim Jesus. That Peter who could not say this in front of one person, that's courage, you know, that's exemplary courage. You know, aisa sahas pavitra atma pradan karta. You know, that is sort of the courage that the Holy Spirit gives. And we know from the church history that of the 12 disciples of Jesus, 11 were martyred for the faith. They died. And willingly, you know, willingly, we are not called to die so much as to live for Jesus. But they were so willing to live that they were even willing to stake their life for Jesus. And we know of Peter, who was so scared, I just spoke. You know, he was hung upside down. Some of them were beheaded. Some were sawed into two. Some were fried in the, you know, boiling oil. Only John the apostle had a natural death. Rest, all of them were martyred. Such fearlessness, that's amazing. Today, we are gripped with this fear, isn't it? You know, Corona, the fear of Corona, you know, that how much, you know, and one of my doctor friends was telling me, many of the people who are coming into hospitals are, the situation is, their condition is getting aggravated because of fear. You know, fear can paralyze us. And here, the Holy Spirit is promising us in the Feast of Pentecost that He will endow us with power. वो हमें पवित्र आत्मा में धैर्य से, शक्ति से, सामर्थ्य से भर देगा. You know, what great promise it this is. And for us, it is to receive. We have to call and ask and get that strength from the Holy Spirit. So the first thing that the Holy Spirit did for the disciples, and He's going to do for each one of us, is to fill us with courage. The second thing that we notice is that the disciples were always bickering, you know, always fighting. Unke aapas mein ladai hoti rehti thi, jhagda hota rehta tha. But you know, in the Gospels, we'll find, no, they are saying, you know, who will sit on the right and left? Peter cannot stand John. John cannot stand James. You know, this was their story. That's our story, in fact. You know, like, and here, after Pentecost, after the receiving of the Spirit, after the outpouring of the Spirit on the day of Pentecost, we read in Acts chapter 2, verse 14, that Jesus, Peter stood up with the 11. Peter stood up with the 11. Wo gyarahon ke saath khada ho gaya. You know, that's as if the Holy Spirit just brought them together. There was a unity that the Holy Spirit brought. And don't we need that Holy Spirit unity in our families, in our communities, in even in our little groups, that in our friend circle? Don't we need that unity? The Holy Spirit provides that. The third thing that the Holy Spirit did was He filled the disciples with this desire to fulfill God's will, to fulfill His will. You know, we can say that about Jesus, it is said, He told, St. John says that about Jesus, that Jesus told His disciples, my will, my food is to do the will of my Father. Mera bhojan apne pita ki marzi pura karna hai. My food is to do the will of my Father. And the same thing that the Holy Spirit transferred that to the disciples. They just wanted to fulfill His will. And that is really the call that each one of us have received. And I believe when we give our lives into the hands of the Holy Spirit, jab hum apne jeevan ko pavitra atma ke haathon mein samarpit kar denge, He will accomplish the very same thing in our life. And holiness is that only, isn't it? You know, holiness is what? Holiness is being one with Jesus. It is not doing certain things or doing certain things. You know, it is being one with Jesus. And this is the call that Jesus is giving us. How did this happen for the disciples? We know that they received the Spirit. Acts 2:4 says that they received the Holy Spirit. Unhone pavitra atma ke samarthya ko paya. Now the Holy Spirit, we have to remember, is a person. Now we know this, you know, because we have been exposed to retreats and, you know, sessions on the Holy Spirit. We know that the Holy Spirit is a person. But that realization has to seep into our hearts. You know, when we say the Holy Spirit is a person, what does it mean when we say He's a person or she is a person? The person has will. अपनी इच्छा शक्ति है उसको. About the Holy Spirit, we read in Acts chapter 7, verse 51, you know, that he do not resist the Holy Spirit. That means he has a will which we can resist. He says, do not resist the Holy Spirit. Again, we read in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 19, do not quench the Spirit. That means you can quench the Spirit. That is a sign of the Holy Spirit having a will, a freedom that the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit can feel, just like you and me can feel, Holy Spirit can feel. St. Paul would say, the letter to Ephesians chapter 4, verse 30, he would say, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. You know, this verse always speaks to me when I read that. Pavitra Atma ko dukhi mat karo. Dukhi mat karo. You know, sometimes by the way we speak, by the way we react, by the way we are not willing to forgive someone who has hurt us, or by the way we hold on to resentment, किस प्रकार से हम अपने दिल में नफरत गुस्सा इस प्रकार की भावना रखते हैं या अपने मुंह से गलत बोलते हैं, यू नो, वी ग्रीव द होली स्पिरिट, हम पवित्र आत्मा को दुखी करते हैं. एंड सेंट पॉल इज टेलिंग अस, डू नॉट ग्रीव द होली स्पिरिट. द होली स्पिरिट कैन स्पीक जस्ट एज यू एंड आई कैन स्पीक. द होली स्पिरिट कैन स्पीक. इन जॉन चैप्टर 16 वर्स 13 ही सेज, जीसस इज टेलिंग अबाउट द होली स्पिरिट, ही सेज ही विल नॉट स्पीक ऑन हिज ओन अथॉरिटी, but he will speak of what he has heard, that he will tell you. John chapter 16, verse 13. Yeah, the Holy Spirit will, only what he hears, he will speak. So he can speak just like us. He can feel, he can think, he can will, he can speak, and he can act. The Holy Spirit can act in our lives. You know, in the Acts of the Apostles, which people say should be called the Acts of the Holy Spirit, one of the very interesting scriptures is Acts chapter 16, verse 6. It says, when Paul wanted, St. Paul wanted to preach in Asia, he was so eager to preach in Asia, the Holy Spirit forbid him to come to Asia. You know, so the Holy Spirit has a very definite way of acting, and he can, you know, he can tell and communicate his will. Can you believe the relationship Paul had, that he could hear it clearly that the Holy Spirit is not wanting me to enter into Asia, even though it's a good thing. So many good things may not be God's thing. Yeah. So sometimes to know that. So the Holy Spirit is a person. So when we say the Holy Spirit is a person, we have to treat him like a person. Now let me give an example. Soch lijiye ki aapke paas ek car hai. You have a car. And every morning when you are going to work or you're going to your college or wherever you're going, you invite a neighbor to come along with you, you know, who is your friend or office colleague. And this person gets into the car, you just wish him good morning or he wishes you good morning. And after he gets into the car, you never say a word. Till, I live in Dilshad Garden. From Dilshad Garden, suppose let's say I'm going to the cathedral, that's where my office is. You know, I take this person every day in my car, 20 kilometers, and I don't say a word to him. I don't say a word. What do you think will happen after maybe a week or maybe a 10 days or maybe even lesser? What will happen? This person will stop coming. Why? Because I am ignoring him. I'm giving him a space. I'm doing something kind, but I don't talk to him. I think you get the drift. Holy Spirit, they say, is the ignored person of the Holy Trinity. How many times do we actually speak to the Holy Spirit? How many times do we actually engage with the Holy Spirit? How many times do we express our love or devotion to the Holy Spirit? And we expect that the Holy Spirit will endow us with power. It's not possible. You know, it's a relationship. It's a relationship. That's why Jesus said, He is with you. He will never leave you. He will be with you forever. But I and you have to cultivate that relationship with the Holy Spirit. And then we will be supercharged. St. Paul, you know, what does St. Paul say? St. Paul says, This is a line that comes up in the Mass, and the priest says it. You can guess which part of the Mass it is. It's in the beginning of the Mass, the middle of the Mass, or the end of the Mass, okay? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Prabhu Yeshu Masih ki kripa, Ishwar ka prem, aur pavitra atma ki sahabhagita aapke saath. Mass mein kahan par aata hai ye? Now, I don't know. You may be guessing it right or wrong. You know, I'll leave it to you. You can find it out later. Okay. But the interesting word there is pavitra atma ki sahabhagita, the communion of the Holy Spirit. Communion means basically being united, so one that my thoughts, my feeling, my everything is belonging to that person. That's communion. That's communion. You know, there are three stages to reach to this, particularly in our relationship with the Holy Spirit. The first stage is we usually have a partnership with the Holy Spirit. The first stage is partnership with the Holy Spirit. Now, when we come to the renewal, or we are exposed to the Holy Spirit in the renewal, or we have an experience of the baptism of the Holy Spirit, the first thing we will do is, like, suppose I have to take a sharing. You know, I call upon the Holy Spirit because I know He is the one who is going to help me. Yeah? Or suppose I have to lead praise and worship, I'll tell the Holy Spirit, please Holy Spirit, mere sahayata karo, mujhe help karo, aaj mujhe achche se praise and worship lead karna hai, Jesus ko mahima deni hai. You know, so I'm asking for Holy Spirit's partnership. Yeah, and the Holy Spirit is so faithful, so good, no? Every time you want to glorify Jesus, He will come, if you ask. Yeah, if you ask is very important. So if you ask, He will come. And when He comes, we do a beautiful praise and worship, or we give a beautiful sharing, or we share our testimony, or we work, or we do any service for Jesus. After that, what happens? Everybody comes up and congratulates us, and he says, wow, you know, fantastic session, beautiful singing, you know. And we say thank you, or we say praise the Lord. But do we actually go back and thank the Holy Spirit? Holy Spirit may be your partner, but sometimes we just treat Him as a partner. I had a friend once, you know, like, in fact, I have the friend still now. This friend was in a business with another guy. They did not share anything. You know, their faith was different. Their language was different. And they had nothing in common apart from the interest in business. So I used to ask, you know, how did you tie up with this guy? He said, no, we have a common interest in business, so we are going along. And somewhere deep down in my heart, I was feeling, you know, this friendship, this partnership is not going to last forever. You know why? Because a common interest just in one thing is not enough. Every partnership should change into friendship. And that's our second stage. And same with the Holy Spirit. Pavitra Atma ke saath mera ek partnership hai. Lekin wo partnership agar dosti mein nahi badalta hai, friendship mein nahi badalta hai, then it will stay at the partnership level. It will be very, very clinical. I will, if for lack of a better word, I will use the Holy Spirit, you know, to pass my exam, to do a praise and worship, or to get a job done. I'll use the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, being a gentleman, would let Himself be used in the hope that you and I will become His friend. So the second stage, from partnership, we must move to friendship. You know, friends spend time, they talk, they listen, they help out. The Holy Spirit will do that for us. And we should listen to Him. So our relationship with the Holy Spirit should go into the level of friendship. But that's not the end. The third and the final level is intimacy. You know, my friendship should go so deep. You know, I can have many friends, but I may have only one or two very intimate friends. Friends who I can bank on, you know, as the young people would say, the 3 o'clock friends, you know, whom you can call at 3 o'clock in the morning and still expect to get a good hearing. You know, that intimacy the Holy Spirit is calling us to. The apostles, the secret of the apostles, of being supercharged, of living out this will of God in their life, was that they had intimacy with the Holy Spirit, closeness. It was a love relationship. They shared everything with the Holy Spirit. You and I are called for that. The apostles are no different than us. In fact, in many of them are far worse than us. Far worse than us. But the Holy Spirit brought them to that place where they could be so intimate with the whole, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit. That relationship brings us to intimacy with the Trinity. You know, the goal of this relationship with the Holy Spirit is not just to get power, is not just to feel, you know, I am a spiritual person, or for others to feel, even, you know, subconsciously people say you're a holy person. No, that's not the end of this intimacy with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit comes into our soul, into our heart, in baptism and in every sacrament for only one purpose. You know what that is? To make us, to change us, to confirm us into the image of Jesus. Hame Yeshu ke saman banane ke liye pavitra atma hamare jeevan mein aata hai. Yeshu ke saman banna hai. We have to become like Jesus. The world needs that. The church needs that. You know, we have to become like. The goal of our relationship with the Holy Spirit is that we become like Jesus. And I cannot emphasize this enough. Remember, it is not to get gifts. He will give you the gifts. He will give you charisms. You know, the ability to sing, to worship, to lead, to preach, to intercede, to serve. These are all gifts of the Holy Spirit. The gift of talking in tongues, all this He will give. But that's not the goal. The goal is that we, in our soul, we are confirmed and we become like Jesus. The image of Jesus. When people look at us, they should say, oh, this is Jesus. This is a disciple of Jesus. This is exactly, you know, they leave a better person just by meeting us. That's the goal. So that the kingdom grows, not just with our words, but with our lives. That's the goal. So when we are coming to this relationship with the Holy Spirit, this intimacy, Saint Therese of Lisieux, she would say something like this, you know. She would say, you can get anything from God, anything, provided you know how to ask. Saint Therese was a brilliant person. You know, the church declared her doctor of the church. A doctor of the church is someone who is a saint and who has a special insight into the Gospels. She died at the age of 24 and the church canonized her and declared her as a doctor. She says, you can get anything, you can receive anything from the Father, provided you know how to ask. And she says, ask for the Holy Spirit. Ask for the Holy Spirit. You know, when we talk about the Holy Spirit, the intimacy of the Holy Spirit, another word is very important. And that word is, remember, the Holy Spirit is God. Is God. So our relationship with the Holy Spirit is based not just like a human friendship. There is a beautiful word in English which we, you know, which is one of the gifts of the Spirit, is one of the gifts that we receive in confirmation. And the gift is fear of the Lord. Hindi mein bole to Prabhu par Shraddha. Prabhu ki Shraddha. The fear of the Lord. When we say the fear of the Lord, the fear of the Lord is not being afraid of God. No. Adam and Eve had the fear of God till they committed the act of sinning by eating the forbidden fruit. After that, it was not fear. After that, they were afraid of God. This fear of God and being afraid of God are two different things. When I do something wrong, I'm afraid of God. When I do a sinful act, I'm afraid of God. Fear of God is the fear which, in other words, if suppose in English, like the word which we call is awe of God, a reverence for God, Shraddha Prabhu ke liye, that He is holy. This God of the universe is my friend. That awe, that reverence for God. Yeah. So don't confuse the fear of the Lord with the being scared of the Lord. You and I don't have to be scared. If our consciences are clear, we don't have to be scared of God. That's why Jesus said, I call you no longer slaves. I call you friends. What a privilege it is. What a privilege. That to know that God is my friend. And the Holy Spirit, Jesus talked about the Holy Spirit. He said, He will be with you and in you. Wo tumhare saath hoga aur tum mein hoga. What a beautiful thing it is. You know, the Holy Spirit is not only just besides us, with us, but inside us. You know, how much ever a person loves us, that person can only be with us. That person cannot be inside us. Of course, we can entertain their thoughts, think about them, all that is possible. But that person cannot be inside us. But Jesus said, He will be within you. So when I put my hand to my heart, and I realize that within my soul dwells this God. That's why Paul could say, you know, my body is a temple of, mera sharir pavitratma ka mandir hai. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. And to have that reverence. There is a beautiful verse in the book of Psalms, Psalm 19, verse 9. It says, the fear of the Lord is clean. The fear of the Lord is clean. No, very surprising verse, isn't it? The fear of the Lord is clean. That means if I have to have this intimacy with the Holy Spirit, everything in my life has to be clean. Particularly my motives, my actions, my thoughts, my, you know, desires, they have to be clean. And the Holy Spirit helps us. He's not condemning us. We all have areas that need to change. All of us. And the Holy Spirit will help us with that. The fear of the Lord is clean. You know, you and me, my dear young people, you know, as we are listening to this, the Holy Spirit will show you what is that needs to change in your heart. Nobody needs to tell us this is wrong in your heart, in your life, because you know it. If I cultivate this fear of the Lord, I will cultivate this desire to set my life in order. Yeah, my thoughts, my speech, my acts, every action of mine will be clean. And then it says, the fear of the Lord is a treasure to those who find. Isaiah chapter 33 verse 6 says, the fear of the Lord is a treasure. Dhan hai, sampatti hai. It's a treasure for those who find it. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, it says. So beautiful. So if I have to come close to the Holy Spirit is, I have to ask for this reverence, this gift that I received in confirmation, the gift of the fear of the Lord, piety and the fear of the Lord, that has to grow in me. The sense that I am in the presence of God, that awe that I can experience. Prabhu ke prati hamara shraddha hame badhana hai. Hallelujah. Just for a moment, just close your eyes and just lift your hands for a moment and just ask the Lord to give you this fear of God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Fill us, Lord, with this fear. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. This reverence, this awe that we need for you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Okay, I mean, we go ahead, you know, and how do we cultivate this intimacy? Hum ye pavitra atma ke saath hamari dosti ko hum kaise badha sakte hain? How do we cultivate? Now, let me tell you a great secret. This is a secret that is reserved for us Catholics. You know, the secret of the intimacy with the Holy Spirit is, the first thing, who is the person in the New Testament who was full of the Holy Spirit? The first person. Yeah, you guessed it right. You know, Mata Maria, you know, Mother Mary. She was full of grace. She was overshadowed. The angel said to her that you will be overshadowed. That means there will be no more of Mary. The Holy Spirit will overshadow. Like, you know, when I think of overshadow, what comes to my mind is, suppose you're standing in front of an elephant. Can you see can your friend or somebody standing on the other side, can they see you? No, impossible. The elephant will overshadow you. Now, some of you may be thinking, who wants to stand, go and stand before an elephant? Yeah, exactly. You'll stay away from the elephant. But the point is, you will never be seen. The Holy Spirit overshadowed Mary like that. Full. You know, the secret is this. And this is a Catholic secret. Huh? The secret is, if you want to have a good relationship with the Holy Spirit, a deep personal relationship, the first thing that you need to do is, you must cultivate a deep love for Mother Mary. Maa Mariam ke saath aapka sambandh sahi hona hai. The church calls Mother Mary the spouse of the Holy Spirit. The spouse. You know, there are spiritual writers who would say that you cannot have, I'm repeating myself, you cannot have an intimacy with the Holy Spirit without having a love and a deep relationship with Mary. You know, to tell this as an open secret, when I came into the renewal many years ago, I won't tell you how long, you know, then you will know that I'm very, very old. When I came to the renewal, I struggled for many years initially to have this relationship with Mary. And thank God that I received that grace. Thank God for that grace. And today, if you and me have to go deeper into a relationship, the first thing is that we must have a relationship with Mary. So it's not just saying rosaries alone. Yeah, that is a way of expressing our love for Mary. Yes, of course. Of course, you have to say the rosary. No, but it is not multiplying and saying so many prayers. It's a love that I have. Do I think about her? Do I offer my day to her? Do I ask her to help me? Our Lady will tell us how to help. Because nobody knew the Holy Spirit, a human being, knew the Holy Spirit as Mother Mary knew. You and me are privileged as Catholics to have this relationship. So, hamare pehli baat kya hai? Hame Maa Mariam ke saath achha sambandh hona hai. Maa Mariam ke saath achha sambandh hoga, to Pavitra Atma ke saath swabhavik roop se hum logon ka sambandh sahi hoga. That's the first point. The second thing is, we must develop this heart of thankfulness and praise. You know, when we honestly, ask yourself, apart from the session like this, when Sini was leading us into worship, we must have praised and thanked the Lord. But on a daily life, when nobody is watching you, quarantine has given us so much freedom that we don't even have to come to church. Yeah? But in our daily life, hum kitne baar Prabhu ko dhanyavaad dete hain? How many times have we actually thanked the Lord? Are we grateful? You know, not thanking mechanically, but being grateful for the Lord. So many blessings He has given us. So many blessings. Even the, you know, Sini was saying the blessing of this technology that we can connect like this. You know, how many times have we thanked the Lord? To have the relationship with the Holy Spirit deep, start thanking the Lord. Being grateful. Live a life of praise and thankfulness. Praise and thankfulness in your daily life. Nobody is watching you. Nobody is your audience. But you are thanking the Lord in your heart, being grateful. Yeah? So the second thing is being grateful. Being grateful also for the gifts that He has. I'll come to that in a moment, okay? The third thing is have a desire for the Holy Spirit and ask Him, Holy Spirit, I want to grow deeper in this relationship. This asking is very important. Huh? Sometimes we do not ask enough. Jesus said, ask and you shall be given. Yeah, seek and you will find. So sometimes we have to ask. Jesus says, of course, I know even before you ask what you want. But asking fosters a relationship. You know, I am never upset if my daughters ask me something. In fact, I'll be upset if they don't ask me. So asking is going deeper into that relationship. God is looking for this. And when we do this, our relationship with the Holy Spirit will grow, you know, grow deeper. Mother Mary, when she's appearing in Medjugorje, okay, of course, these Medjugorje apparitions are not right now completely, like 100%, it's not been approved like Fatima and Lourdes, but Mother Mary has been giving beautiful messages there. And you must read. One of the messages Mother Mary says that here is to the visionaries, she said, the mistake that people make is they don't ask the Holy Spirit. Can you believe? The mistake, she says. We ask, she says, you know, sometimes they ask the saints more than the Holy Spirit. Yeah, this is actually what she said. You don't ask the Holy Spirit. And she says, every morning, ask for the Holy Spirit to come down upon you. Har subah pavitra atma ko mango. Har subah pavitra atma ko mango. Har subah. So when I do that, Mother Mary says, when the Holy Spirit comes, He will do two things. One, He will give clarity to you. He will clear things for you. Clear things for you. Second, He will transform you. So what will the Holy Spirit do? Pavitra Atma aayega. Ma Mariam kehti hai, roj mango subah aap. Har subah aap Pavitra Atma mango. Jab Pavitra Atma aayega, to woh sab kuch spasht kar dega. He will make everything clear. And second, वो हमें रूपांतरित कर देगा. He will transform us into what? Into Jesus. Into Jesus. So we have to ask. There is this beautiful prayer I learned many years ago. And this is a prayer that will help us transform. This is a prayer by Cardinal Mercier. Cardinal Mercier was, it will come up on your screen in a bit. Cardinal Mercier was a very holy Catholic cardinal. He was asked, what is the secret of your sanctity? What is the secret of your holiness? And he said, this prayer, you know, the prayer will come. If it doesn't come up, yeah. So the prayer goes something like this. O Holy Spirit, beloved of my soul, I adore you. Enlighten me, guide me, strengthen me, console me. Tell me what I should do. Give me your orders. I promise to submit myself to all that you permit to happen to me. Let me only know your will. You know, and the way to say this is, let the prayer, as you look at the prayer on the screen, Cardinal Mercier gives us the way to say this. He says, every morning, not once in a week, not once in a month, not before cross connection, every morning, as you get up, sit 5 minutes, close your imagination to everything outside. Close your eyes and say this prayer. Say this prayer slowly, again and again. What are you doing? You're opening yourself to the Spirit and you're saying, Holy Spirit, you enlighten me, you guide me, you strengthen me. And there are things that we need to be consoled. You console me. Tell me what I should do. And He will. Huh? He speaks. Remember, He speaks. And you promise yourself, I submit to you, I give myself to you. And permit, Lord, there are certain things that will happen to us during the day. The Holy Spirit will give us the courage and the strength to bear it. Only, what is my desire through this prayer? Holy Spirit, let me only know and do your will. So like Jesus, we can say, my food is to do the will of my Father. John chapter 4 verse 34. Just my food, mera bhojan, Ishwar ki marzi ko pura karna hai. Say this prayer. It's a beautiful prayer. It has helped me. Another secret I'll tell you. You know, there's a holy bishop who was a priest from our diocese and he became a bishop. I can name him. You all, some of you know him. Bishop Ignatius. He was a spiritual director of the Renewal many years ago. And he gave me this second, the secret of the holiness. You know, he was telling me, every morning I get up and say, good morning, Holy Spirit. The first words out of my mouth is, good morning, Holy Spirit. Ask yourself, what are the first words that come out of your mouth? Don't tell me. What are the first words that come out of your mouth? we are talking about the intimacy with the Holy Spirit. The last and the fourth and the last point. The way to grow in the intimacy with the Holy Spirit is we should be faithful to what the Holy Spirit has asked us. पवित्र आत्मा हमसे बहुत सारी चीजें बोलता है, लेकिन हमारी परेशानी पता है क्या है? हम लोग सुनते हैं लेकिन करते नहीं है. यू नो वी आर लाइक दैट सन हु सेज टू द फादर आई विल गो टू द फील्ड बट ही डज नॉट गो. द होली स्पिरिट इंस्पायर्स अस, ही विल गिव अस इंस्पिरेशंस. Saint Teresa says, Teresa of Lisieux, Saint Teresa of Lisieux, she says, if you have to grow in your relationship, start doing what God is telling you. Now you may say, some of you may say, I don't hear God. God doesn't speak to me. The Holy Spirit doesn't speak to me. I tell you, Holy Spirit speaks to each one of us. The Holy Spirit speaks to each one of us. I'll tell you how. Suppose you're very tired in a day, okay, very tired. You worked the whole day, you studied or whatever you did. You came back home, you had meal, you had a bath, you had a meal and everything. And you're so heavy with sleep that you just want to hit the bed. And as you are about to go and sit on the bed, as you sit on the bed to sleep, you hear a gentle voice within you, pray. Whose voice is that? That's not your voice. Your voice is saying, go to sleep. Whose voice is that? That is the voice of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will tell us. He speaks to us. When we speak harshly to someone, we are in a group of friends, you know, we are sitting together with friends and we make fun of some friends, you know, friend. And sometimes the fun becomes a little too much and we say hurtful things. And the moment we say something hurtful, the Holy Spirit will just give us a little indication in our heart. What do we usually do? We'll say, "Arey yaar, wo to main mazak kar raha tha. Tu kyun serious ho gaya? Main mazak kar raha tha." But the Holy Spirit has told us that we went a little overboard. Hum thoda zyada bol diye. If we have to listen to the inspiration at that very moment, we must stop. And the next opportunity, we must make peace with that person. The other person may say, "No, no, no, it's okay." But from our side, we must make peace. And internally, we have to tell the Holy Spirit, thank you for that inspiration. Thank you for stopping me. Sometimes we may not be able to. Mother Mary says, the Holy Spirit will not come to you. Yeah, one of the messages of Medjugorje is, she will not come, the Holy Spirit will not come to you unless you are ready to forgive. Challenge, isn't it? Everyone who has hurt us, we need to forgive. And the Holy Spirit will tell us. If we sit before Him, He'll tell us what is to be done. The Holy Spirit will give us inspiration. And during this lockdown, He has spoken to you. Some of you have listened to what He has said. Some of you have not listened. I am one of those who have not listened also. You know, I remember I was asking the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, you know, ever since Vivian told me that, you know, there is this session, I've been praying much to the Holy Spirit. And I told Holy Spirit, what do you want me to do? You know what He said? He did not ask me to prepare. He did not ask me to go and read the scriptures or, you know, make this talk or anything. You know what He told me? He told me in my heart, call this person up. And He started showing some friends of mine whom I have not called for ages. They are in my phone book, but I have not called them. So every day He would tell me one or two people's names and I started calling them up. You know, two people's, I called them exactly on their birthday. So you know how good a friend I am, okay, to them. I'm very bad with birthdays. But I, you know, Holy Spirit led me to call them on their birthdays. They said, you know, bhaiya, it is our birthday today. I said, thank God, you know, you told me. Otherwise, I would be terribly embarrassed if when I put the phone down that, you know, like I called you and I did not wish you. So the Holy Spirit will give us simple inspirations like that. And I know He has spoken to you. So this evening, before you sleep, sit with the Holy Spirit and say, Holy Spirit, what didn't I listen to you? What are the areas that you told me? Maybe the Holy Spirit will tell you, not something, you know, something spectacular, go out and do this great service for people. He may be telling you, do the dishes at home today. Without your mother or your sister or someone telling you this. Just do the dishes. And the Holy Spirit has been telling you this. Do this little job at home. Or be a little charitable to somebody. Simple. simple things like that. Simple things like that. And we, the more we listen to the Holy Spirit, jitna hum sunenge Pavitra Atma ki awaaz ko, utna uski awaaz hamare jeevan mein loud hoti jayegi. And then we will live this supercharged life. Yeah. So I'm just throwing some pointers. Okay. Like, I'm sure the Holy Spirit speaks to you. I'm sure of that. One of the things he did is to call you to this meeting. That's his work. Huh? That's his work. You may have read the invite, but there would have been 10 other things you could have done, but the Holy Spirit called you. So I want to say to you this. You all have the Holy Spirit by the virtue of a baptism, by the virtue of a confirmation, and in every sacrament. But be aware now. Know how to reverence him, how to love him, how to be close to him, and how not to grieve him. Usko dukhi nahi karna hai. He is very sensitive. Do not let us grieve him. And we pray for each other that we all grow in this relationship with the Holy Spirit. And as we prepare ourselves for the adoration, we are going to meet Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. Nothing is more beautiful than that. And Jesus knows our heart. Jesus knows our heart. And as we prepare to receive Jesus, don't go away. You know, we may have overshot the time by a little bit. Just stay under 15 minutes. We're just going to adore Jesus. Sini is going to lead us. And we are just going to pray. Pray for many people. I know of a young Jesus youth. I just got a call from his sister just before I was getting into the session that he has been diagnosed with COVID. He's in the hospital in Delhi. Pray for so many people like that. Our friends, our family members. Pray that we will all be guided by the Spirit and come closer to Jesus. You know, it's been a pleasure talking to you. And I know you always have been a beautiful, beautiful people you are. Beautiful people. You know, and I'm happy, so happy to be with you. You give me life. You know, the moment I think of Jesus Youth, I think of your commitment to Jesus. God bless you for that. Thank you for this organizers who organize so beautifully. You know, they did. So God bless you. We'll enter into adoration and then we will end with another 15, 20 minutes of adoration and then we'll close. God bless you.
Thank you so much, Matthew Bhaiya, for that beautiful session on how we should grow from a level of partnership and friendship into a much more deeper level of intimacy with the Holy Spirit. And it was really beautiful listening to all that Matthew Bhaiya said, and so much to reflect on, so much that we may not be doing and the Lord is calling us to do. And here is our time. We are going to enter a beautiful time face to face with the Lord, where we can directly speak to God, speak to our Jesus, and ask him to give us these graces and give us a new and fresh and a more powerful outpouring of his Holy Spirit, who can be with us throughout our days. So without any more delay, we will go into this beautiful time of adoration, where we will adore our Jesus, present in the most blessed sacrament. We are really privileged and blessed, I feel, to have these moments of adoration with our Lord. So let's just make most of this time where it's just going to be a one-to-one conversation with our Jesus in the most blessed sacrament. So as we sing this song, Father, We Adore You, I invite you all to join with me in adoring and praising this Jesus of ours, this Lord of ours, present in the Blessed Sacrament. Father, we adore you. Lay our lives before you. How we love you. Jesus, we we As we look at this beautiful Lord of ours, enthroned amidst us, so beautiful, so spotless, it's such a blessed moment that we all are experiencing right now, the presence of our Lord Jesus Himself. Our Lord has personally called us, each one of us, by our names, to be present before Him and to adore Him and to speak to Him. No amount of thanks can suffice, my dear friends. This God of ours, who created everything, every single thing within us and around us, and yet He's so humble that out of His love for us, He took the form of a small bread, of the small host, so that we could wrap our minds around this, about His, how big He is, just for our understanding and for our eyes to see. Our Lord made Himself so small for our sake, and He sits in front of us. What more could I ask of my Lord? Like what Mary did. She just sat at your feet, just looking at you as you spoke. She did nothing else. Lord, I feel as blessed as Mary was that day when you went into their house, into the house of Martha and Mary. Lord, so too you have come today into my house, into my heart, right in front of me, Lord. And for this, I want to thank you, Lord. For this and all the things, Lord Jesus, that you have been continuously blessing my life with and filling my life with, I want to thank you, Lord. We bless your name, Jesus. We exalt your name, O Lord.
Together,
we Lord Jesus, we exalt your name on high. We love you, Lord, for you loved us first. And out of your love for us, Lord Jesus, you gave your life for us. And Lord, so that every day we can see you and we can touch you and we can experience you. You reduced yourself, Lord Jesus, to the size of this host, ready to be broken for us. Thank you, Lord, for loving me, Lord, in spite of who I am. In spite of me, Lord Jesus, not having responded to your call, not having responded to your Holy Spirit that came and called to me in so many instances. You have loved me, Jesus. And Lord, these times, this current situation, Lord Jesus, also disturbs me. It distracts me, Lord Jesus, from just being in your presence so very often, that I'm very often carried away by the worries and anxieties that every day brings. As we sit in the presence of our Jesus, let's ask for his forgiveness for all the times where we did not pay heed to him and his gentle Holy Spirit speaking to us. The times that when the Lord was prompting us to get into an intimate relationship with him through the Holy Spirit, and we denied. We put it off for later. Let's ask sorry. Let's ask pardon to our God. Especially these times, these days have been so full of distractions by our own anxieties and worries that we've often had. In spite of the Lord assuring us again and again, him saying, "Do not fear, for I am with you." We have not paid heed. We are sorry, Jesus. We are sorry, Lord. We've heard of the verse in the Bible, in the book of Matthew, where Jesus calls Peter. He calls out to Peter to walk with him on the waters. And Peter just fixes his gaze on the Lord. And walks upon the waters, trying to reach out to the Lord. I feel even in these times of insecurities and all the trouble that surrounds us, Jesus is extending his hand towards us, calling out to us to walk upon these troubled waters. And he's telling us that all you need to do is just fix your gaze upon me, and everything else will just fade away. All your worries will just fade away. So let us, as we continue to look at this beautiful face of our Lord Jesus, sing this song of praise. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Let's sing this together. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and as we further read in this verse in the book of Matthew, that even as Peter was walking upon the waters, just fixed, having his gaze fixed upon Jesus, all of a sudden he is disturbed by the worries and the waves that he sees around him. So disturbed that he suddenly looks away from Jesus. And that is the time he begins to sink. He begins to sink into the waters. I feel we too may be weak, like Peter, so often that we tend to look away from Jesus, and we often tend to magnify our worries and our concerns instead of just looking at Jesus and allowing him to be in control. Here, Jesus is giving us a chance once again to take a fresh look at him once again, to not be distracted, to just continue looking at him and loving him. And he's assuring us that he's in control. So like Peter, if there have been times in these last couple of months when we've given priority to other things and other worries to take control of us rather than the person of Jesus, every moment that we've looked away from him, let's just tell the Lord that, Lord, it is nothing else that can give me comfort. It is only your presence that can comfort me, that can give me peace. Lord, I'm desperate for you. I'm completely lost without you, Lord. So come and fill me, Lord Jesus, once again. Lord, your presence, may it surround me and fill me. May I learn to live on your word, that it becomes my daily bread. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your every word spoken to me, and I take this moment of silence. Let's just experience the Lord's loving embrace, comforting us. Jesus standing right in front of us and wanting to embrace us, wanting to start afresh where we place all our confidence and trust in Him. Like Peter did. And when he did, the Lord lifted him on high. He was filled with the Holy Spirit. So let us take this one moment to experience the loving embrace of our Lord Jesus. And as we thank God for this beautiful time that we had adoring Him, Let us tell Jesus that, Lord, I continue needing you. I will always need you, Lord, to be with me and your Holy Spirit to guide me in everything that I do. Thank you, Lord, for coming in front of me and allowing me to speak to you, Lord. I bless your name, Lord Jesus. As we are coming to the end of this time of adoration, let's thank God once again.
Oh, sacrament most holy, oh, sacrament divine, oh, praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. Thank you so much for leading us into that beautiful time of worship. Thank you so much, Sanitary, for leading us into this beautiful time of adoration. It felt really good. We're so blessed to see Jesus in the comfort zones of our homes and to adore him together. And thank you so much. So lastly, I also want to thank Matthew Bayer, who is sharing, breaking the word with us. Thank you so much, Matthew Bhaiya. I think this was something that we really wanted to hear. It was like some points that I think that really touched me, and I personally would like to work on with, you know, we know that Holy Spirit is a person. We know that already, but you know, we've learned it. But sometimes, you know, it becomes it's a struggle to just make it very personal, you know, like just having that conversation. Like you mentioned that the Holy Spirit can speak, he can act, he can, you know, he can communicate his will to us. And sometimes all that we really have to do is just, you know, be open to the promptings of the Holy Spirit. So thank you so much, Matthew. Another point, actually, I really loved one thing that you shared, and I really want to share this with all of you guys. Holiness is being one with Jesus. You know, it is not doing anything extraordinary. It is not doing a certain set of things, but it's to be united, to be one with the Lord. And I think Mother Mary is that one person with whom, from whom we can learn. And so we can take Mother Mary as an inspiration, and you know, that's how we can be one with the Lord, and we can make Holy Spirit that person in our life, that living tangible person in our life. So thank you so much, Matthew Bhaiya, and thank you so much, Sini Bibi, for leading us into this beautiful time of adoration. Thank you so much to both of you. God bless you guys. So before we say a final goodbye, I want to just quickly, maybe we can all just say a Hail Mary for both of our resources. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Amen. And peace. So this is the end of our supercharged cross connection, guys. But before we go, I have a few announcements to make. And before that, we also have to celebrate our birthdays. So just put in the comments, all of you guys who celebrated your birthday in the month of June, in the month of May, probably after we had our last cross connection. Those who will be celebrating their birthday in the coming weeks, please put in your comments, your names. You can also maybe say the names of your friends, your husband, wife, father, mother, anybody. Any anniversaries? We've celebrated in the last few weeks or in the coming few weeks. Please put that as well. We would love to pray for all of you guys who have had celebrations during this pandemic or are about to have celebrations during this pandemic. So please put in the comment. So Joel is celebrating his birthday on the 26th of this month. Okay. Who else? Oh, also today is Father's Day. So happy Father's Day to all the amazing fathers out there, all the expectant fathers, all spiritual fathers. Thank you for being a father. Thank you for just being you. In today's time and culture, we're somewhat losing the true meaning of fatherhood and what it truly means to be a father. And it's so amazing that in our Jesus Youth Circle, we have amazing fathers who are an inspiration to so many young parents, young fathers. We also have priests. They are also fathers. So we also have amazing priests who pray for us, who inspire us to grow in holiness. So happy Father's Day to all you fathers out there. Any more birthdays? Okay, it seems like not many people are celebrating their birthday in the month of June, July. So we'll quickly just say a small prayer for Joel. Okay, Reba says celebrating our first anniversary on the 30th of this month. Yes, Reba and Vivin are two amazing people of Jesus Youth Movement, Jesus Youth Delhi. They're celebrating their first anniversary. They celebrated their first anniversary. They are celebrating their first anniversary on the 30th of this month. So, anybody else? Okay, so since we only have two people who commented, we can quickly say a small prayer for them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord Almighty, we thank and praise you for the gift of Joel in our lives. Lord, we pray for this amazing person who will be celebrating his birthday in a few days. We thank you for the amazing person that he is. We pray that you may bless him, bless all his endeavors, that you may guide him. We pray, O Holy Spirit, that you may fill him with all your gifts and fruits. We also pray for Reba and Vivin, who are celebrating their very first anniversary this month. Holy Spirit, we pray that you may bless them abundantly, that you may fill them with all the graces that they need to make each other saints, to help each other in growing in holiness. Mama Mary, we ask your special intercession on all of these people and all those who are celebrating their birthdays in the coming weeks. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Amen. So I'll quickly make a few announcements. But before that, I actually want to, there was a small mistake from my side. I got a little confused. So the first question that we had, the question was, how many days after Jesus was ascended into heaven did the Holy Spirit come down? So the answer is actually 10. So it was 50 days after resurrection and 10 days after ascension. So I think I made a small mistake by saying 10, just got confused. So 10 is the right answer, guys. Again, thanks to all of you guys who participated, with so much enthusiasm. So now coming back to the announcements, we know that every day at 12:30 p.m., live Mass is being celebrated for all of us across the world from the Jesus Youth International Office. And you can find the link on the Jesus International YouTube page, on the Instagram page, on Facebook page. So wherever you guys are, you know, just set a reminder, and automatically if you're online during that time, it will pop up. So let's utilize this opportunity of attending daily mass in the comfort of our homes. Secondly, we have this 9 p.m. Prayer that we've been doing every day in Jesu Delhi. So some of us have been coming together and praying together for the world, for all our intentions. Again, you can find the link on jesudelhi.org. Also, you can reach out to us on our Facebook page, and we can share the details with you guys. Thirdly, we have this amazing Spotify playlist. I'm sure a lot of us will be supercharged, you know, simply by listening to a good song. And who doesn't like listening to, you know, some of these amazing songs that that are there out there? So there's this Spotify playlist called Reven Celebration. So these are songs which have been, you know, we've used these in our retreats and our conferences in the past, and I've been listening to it, and you know, it's always, I mean these songs are always, I'm playing it in the back of my mind always, and it's beautiful, you know. We can listen to these songs, and we can get ourselves supercharged. So go follow these, go follow the link on Spotify, the playlist on Spotify. So another announcement is, so a few weeks ago we actually launched this song called Mere Tum, which was again by our band Acts of the Apostles. They launched the song a few weeks ago, and the song has been such a super hit, guys. Like literally from all parts of the world, people have been pouring their comments, their, you know, how much the song has really touched their life. And today we're celebrating Father's Day, and you know, the song is about father's love. So before going to sleep, do listen to the song once before going to sleep, and let's celebrate Father's Day like that. Another announcement is that we've been having our prayer meetings quite regularly. The campus ministry has been meeting quite often, and you know, it's so nice to just come together and just be part of a youth prayer group, especially during this time of pandemic, you know, just to help each other and support each other. And it's been a beautiful journey. So I would request you all to, you know, reach out to us if you are willing, if you're a youngster who is looking for fellowship during this time of pandemic. If you want to reach out to us, please feel free to reach out. You can reach out to us on Facebook, Instagram, we're on Twitter, you know, wherever wherever possible, wherever you're active. I don't think we're on TikTok yet, but you know, just reach out to us and we will guide you. We have an amazing prayer meeting for campus students. So if any of you guys are campus students here who are looking for fellowship, please reach out to us. Yes. So that's what's going on here. So here's the link. Link is links.jesudelhi.org. That's where you can go and find the link. And then lastly, we have a prayer request WhatsApp number. So guys, I know we're all going through this pandemic. It's really hard. You know, we're all in isolation, and we're not able to go out and, you know, have as much personal contact and talk to people as much. And it's hard, you know. I know it. I'm somebody who loves to just be with people, and just sitting inside the four walls of my house, I get frustrated sometimes, and I'm sure all of us do. It's really sad. And like a few days ago, we heard about Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide. It was so sad, again, to hear something about that. And you know, since then we've been talking a lot about mental health and things like that. So anyway, coming back to the point, if you have any prayer requests, if you're going through a tough time, if you want to talk to somebody, if you have any query related to your faith, anything, please feel free to reach out to us on this number that is mentioned here. We will respond back to you ASAP, and that's a promise. So I think that's it with our announcements. We are coming to an end of our Cross Connection virtual edition. So thank you so much for joining in, guys. I love you all, and thanks for all those who stayed till the end. Means a lot. Praise the Lord, and go have your dinner, you know, go to sleep, watch a movie, do whatever you want, and keep yourself supercharged. So thank you. Bye.